Hello friends of the Northern Entertainment and welcome to a first look. Incident Commander was suggested yesterday during the stream by somebody. And yeah, we have a look here. It is an early access game. It is single player, multiplayer. I do not have it as multiplayer running right now. We're just going to do a single player. I'm going to show you guys what you can expect from the game. So let's have a look here in a single player. And you have the tutorial, learn how to play. I did that already, so we don't have to worry about that. Then we have the wildfire, we have a school shooting, and we have a chemical spill. We are going to look at the wildfire today because, as you guys know, I come from a town that burned down, but 25% of the town burned down in 2011. So wildfires are very close and near and dear to my heart. And as you guys know, last year this season I was also involved here in a couple of evacuations where we helped evacuating people with search and rescue. But anyways, neither here or there. The game itself, as I'm gonna start this now, Incident Command. Now, if you are in any way, shape or form, if you have anything to do in any way, shape or form with emergency services, then you will know the ICS, the Incident Command System. And this is really, you can tell that whoever made this game has some kind of ICS training, because you will see how this is all gonna here go down. First of all, we need very quickly, I need you guys here. So the graphics of the game, first of all, are interesting, shall we say. Vastly different from, for example, vastly different from a game like Emergency, which obviously has, while it has dated textures, it's still still vastly different than what you see here. I mean, this is more something that I would almost expect to see on a console, maybe. The fire textures are not terrible at all. The voices that you can hear are very generic. But let's set the command up, because before too long we're gonna have so strategic actions. And this is where you have the ICS, yeah, Incident Command System. There it is right there. So you have the Incident Commander, of course. That's your first thing. So as the IC, we're gonna place our command post somewhere here. Then as an IC, I want the PIO. The PIO is gonna placed around here. And this is where the media will gather, because if you do not have this in a major event, then you will have media meandering or moseying up to your scene and cause all kinds of issues that we don't need. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna drag those vehicles out of harm's way here. We have, as you can see, the fire department here already. Can you turn your sirens off? Unfortunately, and I guess this is again something that I'm just used to from Emergency 4, is that the lights stay on. And overall, you don't have to worry about things. Yeah, you don't have to worry about things like hose connections and all that stuff, because the main thing is about the ICS. Or, well, see, this is the thing. It is an RTS that is based on the ITS, so it's a strategic game that is based on the ICS. However, I find that while this is a really good, well, there are really good intentions, the game is very slow. Now, when you play it online, and I think you see it here, online player can take different roles here. So you have the air branch, you have the operations section chief, definitely. We need a helicopter landing pad, because that's gonna help with our, with getting everything here in place. Roger. We can also evacuate with that, so I am going to fly those two out just because it's going to be faster. But yeah, that said,
yes, let's do this.
The The ideas are definitely not bad, but you can see how... Yeah, how... Move out. I don't know how to exactly explain it to you. I don't know what exactly I want to say about this, because it's just... On a console, on a phone, yes, absolutely, great game. On PC, I just expect more.
Yes.
Okay, you could say, well, this is maybe for the younger generation. Why bother about the ICS then? I mean, yes, okay, you can get them, acquainted with the ICS, but.
Let's go.
I just feel that the game, the intentions are good, most definitely, but it's just, it... Those three missions that you have are fun. I will say that much. But it's just so, so slow in... Yeah, I don't know.
Let's do this.
Move here, and the reason I want to move here before I send him Phil Bucket is because he will come back. Now, overall,
let's do this.
This is a very much simplified version of, I don't even want to say Emergency 4, honestly. It can get pretty gritty, because when you do the,
reporting in.
It can get pretty dark. When you do
Roger.
The
yes
now when you do the what's it called now
let's do this
the school shooting when you do that one then yeah it's
affirmative.
It's getting dark in a hurry. I mean, school shooting is of course something is a dark topic to begin with.
Affirmative.
There is our helicopter. Drop the water. There we go. We're gonna play, or I'm gonna finish this mission.
Yes.
There we go. Go fill ye bucket. There is also no wind that is taken into consideration or anything of the like. Now, what's nice is you can actually you can call certain units in here, as you can see. And one that I will call in is a fire dozer, because with a dozer we can put a firebreaker right here. And then we don't have to worry about this and or the rest of the town. That being said, over here we have some fire too. So I might start the break here because we have the helicopter somewhere.
Move out.
And here you have the public safety risk. At the moment it is a medium risk incident, and the incident budget, we are within budget.
Let's go.
So I'm gonna keep that. Let's see, we're gonna...
Let's go.
Where are we going to drop the water? Here.
Let's do this.
Drop that water!
Let's go.
There you go. Good man.
Roger.
Yeah, I would have loved if you could have... Yeah, that was my own fault.
Let's go.
If the water would have dropped here, that would have been better, because this house here... is still quite endangered.
Ready.
Actually, Roger. You boys have to move Let's back go. Here. And you can see how slow everything moves. So this is definitely not at the pace of an Emergency 4
Roger.
Or Emergency 5 at that. So here you have the media team now, as you can see. And yeah, as I said, if you don't have the Joint Information Center set up, then they will be...
Roger that.
They will be meandering around here in your
Ready for orders.
In your accident scene, and that is really, really, really annoying. There comes the helicopter again, so let's drop that water right here.
Affirmative.
please and thank you.
Let's do this. Roger.
There you go. Good job. And fill a bucket. And the dozer is here. Well, we don't need him in the staging area. And what I like about the game is that it will actually use ICS terminology, like staging area, the incident command, and so on and so forth.
Move out.
So that part is nice. I just feel like it's hard to describe what I feel about this. I would think it's more fun in multiplayer.
Yes.
Dude, Roger. I said I need you up here because I need to create a fire break in a hurry. Yeah. Helicopter, please come back. Okay, as it is, now we can speed this up to what I call the normal speed. This puts it a little bit more at a reasonable speed, as you can see.
I'm ready.
And it's still even on the fast
let's go.
Yeah, even on that fast setting.
Let's do this.
We are still good. So he's gonna start on the fire breach now.
Move out. Affirmative.
Okay.
Move out.
I'll drop the water here because this is getting really close to that house.
Roger.
Didn't get that far. Oh yeah, got the fire. Okay, fill the bucket.
Move out. Roger.
So continue on here, please. I like the way that you set this up, and I also like the way you won't see it here, but the police can set up
move out. Roger.
Now what are you guys doing?
Move out.
Okay.
Affirmative.
Drop the water here.
Roger.
And that should take care of all of this.
Let's go.
There we go. Perfect.
Let's go.
All right, we have a little bit of fire left here. Nothing to write home about though. Okay.
Yes. Yes. Affirmative.
So I might just put the fire break around this and let it burn out. I don't know. Maybe. I don't know yet. Obviously, we're gonna utilize the helicopter.
Roger that.
Gonna get this done up here. But Roger. Yeah, it is a little bit annoying that there is no wind that's
affirmative.
That's taken into consideration.
Affirmative. Let's do this.
Okay.
Affirmative. Let's do this.
Do your thing here, buddy.
Yes. Roger that.
And the soundtrack, this is kind of meh.
That.
And you can't turn it off either.
Affirmative. Roger that. Yes.
How are we doing here with our fire break? Oh yeah.
Affirmative.
Good, good. See, if there was wind, I would only have to worry about putting the fire break in front of the fire. As it is, this fire spreads almost equally into all directions, so it's a little bit annoying.
Roger.
But as you can see, just like
let's go.
In a real life situation, air operations are of vital importance in a scenario like this.
Yes.
Now,
affirmative.
Again, I'm not only talking about the negative. The positive here is the firefighter crews will actually, within reason, continue on their little ways and continue fighting the fire that is within their reach.
Let's go.
And by doing so, take a little bit of pressure off you as the IC.
Roger.
It's
Roger that.
tends to argue that if you actually play as just the IC, it's getting a little bit boring for you, probably, if you really have all your positions filled. Okay, boys, you know what? You can go here now.
Move out.
I mean, this is gonna...
Roger.
If we don't start doing something from here, then yes, it's not going past the fire break, but it's gonna take forever. And as it is, I think we're gonna be quick enough here that I can show you guys also the chemical spill. I don't want to get into the... Well, I guess I could even show you the... Yeah, we're gonna look at all three scenarios. I'm just gonna take a cut here, make a jump cut to the end of this mission so you can see how that looks. And then we go on to have a look at scenario number two, which is a chemical spill.
Affirmative. Move out. Move out.
Now here's something that I wanted to show you guys. I know I said I make a quick cut, and I did make a quick cut, but this is definitely something that you should see as well, and that is looters are a problem.
Let's do this. Yes.
So we're gonna be sending the police, and then you're gonna arrest him.
Let's go.
The way you arrest him is funny, though.
Let's do this.
You are under arrest. Uh-oh.
Roger. Let's do
this. And he is arrested. Now, what I can show you guys here is you can escort people out.
Roger.
Come on.
Yes.
I'm gonna escort them here. And then we're gonna go ahead here. I have to go back to that here right away. So now we can go stop escorting, and then we set up a perimeter.
Let's go.
Like so. And then people will stay away from this area. It's also really important if you don't have the joint information center up that you cordon off certain areas. All right, how we doing here? Now he's almost done with this fire breach completely. It's good. Or fire break.
Ready for war, Roger.
Where's my helicopter? Okay,
yes.
Build a bucket. We definitely have to get water on this.
Let's go.
And I would say that's good enough.
Roger that.
So, again, I will be back once we have this scenario done.
Roger that.
So, this is the end of this incident, so we can declare the incident over, which ends the game. And here's our after action report. There we go. Undo cost. Pfft, whatever. So our scenario briefing, the general situation, the time, 0827 on a warm spring day, tanker train containing dangerous liquid chemicals derails at the main intersection in Troubletown. After several minutes, a nearby unlocker collapses, overcome by fumes emanating from one of the train car's punctured tanks. The suspicious liquid is slowly but steadily leaking from a damaged tank and begins forming a pale yellow gaseous cloud as it makes contact with the atmosphere and evaporates. The warehouse is very close to the incident and may need to be evacuated. And so on and so forth. Yeah, so here we go. We thankfully have one unit.
Ready for Roger that.
We thankfully have the police nearby. We thankfully have utility services nearby, and a utility pole has just been fallen. Ready for so friends, get quickly into your van. And let's do this here.
Reporting in.
Yeah.
Let's go.
All right, let's evacuate people. Hello. Yeah, explosions all over the place.
Reporting in.
Get that vehicle out there, please, in a hurry.
Ready for orders.
Ah.
Yes.
Toggle those sirens.
Yes.
Get the people away from here.
Let's go.
Okay. You boys.
Yes.
Do this. And
yes.
They are starting to turn this off. Oh, this is no good.
Ready.
You might move want out. To get on this one here. Oh no. There's the media team. So now you can see, since I don't have the joint public there. You guys can hang out there because I really don't want you guys here.
Yes.
Where's my squad?
Yes.
Come on, grab him.
Let's go.
Grab him.
Yes. Roger. Move out.
Don't wander off. Exactly. Stop escorting. Perimeter will be set. Choop.
Roger.
Right there.
Roger.
Okay, what we need is fire operations, and I need a hazmat team. Oh, right. I should maybe place my. I see.
Roger that.
I see we'll be up here and casualties will be gathered here.
Yes. I'm ready. Yes. Roger.
We do have to be careful because you can see here if this collapses, we have all kinds of problems.
Roger.
I need hazmat. And then a hazmat team is gonna take 8 minutes to show up, so it's gonna take a moment.
Yes. Roger. Move out.
But yeah, this is pretty much how this is all working.
Yes.
It's it's definitely not an emergency 4 or an emergency 5. It's
Roger that.
Just simple. Okay, that has been repaired.
Move out.
Now we're gonna.
Let's go.
The media team is here. The IC is here. Our.
Let's do this.
Oh yeah, see, this is where we need you guys now.
Yes.
Let's start evacuating people. All right, undo cost. Well, I don't think it's undo. The way this whole situation is presenting itself here. What's weird too is that it needs 4 people to transport 1 casualty. But hey, who am I to judge?
Ready for orders. Roger.
So now you're gonna see how this works too. You're gonna bring them here to the tent and then you click on release. And that will release the patient, put them automatically on a stretcher or into a...
Roger.
Into the appropriate place anyway. And there's a robbery going on.
Ready. Yes.
Quickly.
Ready for orders. Roger that.
But because it is so slow. Yeah, because the gameplay is so slow, it doesn't really give you that sense of urgency
Let's go.
That you have with emergency, for example.
Ready for orders.
So I think it's a good game for your kids if you want to get them interested in the emergency services, if you want to get them interested if you want to get them started early on ICS. But for us, I don't know.
Yes. Affirmative.
It's
let's do this.
Okay, here we have
Roger that.
Arrest has to be made. What are you guys doing? I mean, the graphics remind me even a little bit of Keep the Peace. All right, so they are doing their thing here.
Let's do this.
Can you please not take the casualty into the
Roger.
Into the stuff there? But you can see here also our firefighter crews have lost a little bit of health based on. Now we are waiting for the. Keep in mind we are still waiting for the hazmat team to arrive, so we can take care of this.
Roger that.
Doodle-doo-doo.
Affirmative.
What I want. That's what I was expecting. I was just about to say.
Let's do this.
I want to get this under control before. Before exactly this happens. But okay. It's too late now.
Let's go.
Okay, all traffic lights have been repaired. So now you guys can go back here and turn this one out. Off. Not out. Off. Off. Off.
Ready for orders. Let's do this.
Grab him. I'm not even worried about getting ambulances here just to keep the cost low. Even though realistically I should have ambulance there, but. Alright, so our hazmat squad is here, and now you have to see this. You have to see it to believe it.
Ready for orders.
Okay, we're gonna evacuate our last victim for now. But yeah, now look how the hazmat crew is gonna take care of this. So at this point, I'm gonna speed this up a little bit. Tiny little bit concerned about the fact that there's barrels that are on fire.
Let's do this.
So we are going Let's to go. Take care of this now.
Move out.
Here we go. Yeah, and this is Let's basically go. How this is now gonna go all the way
Let's
through.
Do this.
Ready until for they are done. So yeah, this was the last little bit of it, and I mean, I think the video was long enough at this point. You get a total of 60 minutes gameplay at this point. I don't know if they are planning on releasing any more versions or not. As I said, it is fun, but for 60 minutes gameplay, the money is not justified, I think, at this point anyway. It is, of course, early access. We might see something more coming down the line, and I will definitely keep my eye on it. But at the moment, I cannot recommend you guys buy this. I hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Until next time, Northern Alex signing off. Thanks for watching, and God bless.